This is a quick hit video. In these videos, I will provide my impressions, experiences, and observations of a product, all within about 5 minutes. This is not a substitute for the full review, but ongoing updates until the full review is done, or supplemental updates to reviews previously completed. Audiophile companies are neck deep in the gamer community. Headphones that were not designed for competitive gameplay will get marketing using e-game credentials. The internet is replete with the corpses of ugly plasticky gaming gear. One of my pet peeves is the silly false gamer-centric marketing audiophile companies implement. Burson, Shit Audio, Odyssey, and others claim they make products for the gaming community, but if you take a step back and a look at what these guys actually offer, you will quickly notice it's all a facade. If Shit or Burson are going to claim they have a gaming DAC, then they need to explain how it's really for gamers. Putting a mic jack on the front does not help win their argument, especially when there isn't an independent mic volume control on the product to begin with. That's kind of the reason I went for the Sound Blaster G6. When I bought the Odyssey LCD GX last year to review, I wanted to grab a gaming DAC to put the GX through its paces. And when I looked online, I found a few options from Sennheiser and Sound Blaster. Feature for feature though, Sound Blaster had it nailed down. The G6 is not the best built DAC I've ever seen. There's a lot of plastic on it. It is light and easily moves on your desk when you plug in your headphones. It's not the most attractive product either. But aesthetics aside, the G6 has some of the most impressive features that make real-world differences. For instance, the G6 is plug-and-play with Macs, PC, PS4, PS5, Xbox, and the Nintendo Switch. It's got 32-bit PCM support, optical, USB, line-in and line-out connections, and a separate mic and headphone jack. The G6 has virtual 7.1 surround sound, which is a far cry from true surround sound, but worth mentioning anyway. The G6 has plenty of power for most headphones. In fact, ASR measured it and found nearly 250 milliwatts at 33 ohms and just under 90 milliwatts at 300 ohms. The amp section has independent amplification for the left and right channels, which is not something you typically see on gaming DAC amps, let alone audiophile DAC amps. But the jewel in the crown is the Sound Blaster desktop application. This, in my opinion, is the cream of the crop where DAC and application collaboration is concerned. The desktop app is able to control various functions of the G6, including modifying frequency, activating the footstep enhancement, adjusting mic volume, creating EQ presets, and much more. The only thing the desktop app cannot do is function as a music playback software, such as Foobar. This is a powerhouse system. This is what a gaming DAC amp should be. This is feature for feature the top of the line. Maybe this DAC does not measure the best on ASR, but that makes no realistic difference. And while it is far from the most powerful amp in the market, the G6 drives dynamic driver headphones without trouble, and it was even able to push planar such as the LCD GX and Aventone planar. The G6 has a transparent, clean sound. It's as good as many other audiophile-grade DACs. If you're among those who thinks that higher and higher dynamic range in a DAC is somehow relevant, then the G6 has a dynamic range of 130 decibels. That is well outside anything you're listening to or will ever listen to. If I sound overly positive about the G6, it's because the product deserves the praise. It is not often that a company provides features that have a real-world impact, so when I find a product that does as much as the G6, it's hard to restrain my joy. You must have seen the various DACs and amps that sit on my desk and get rotated in and out. I'm sure some of you might love to try them out. But when I am gaming, as infrequent as it is, I plug in my G6. Not the Burson 3XR, iFi iDSD, Brooklyn DAC Plugs, Matrix Mini I Pro 3, or any of the rest. The application and DAC integration is superb on the G6. There's nothing else in the audiophile universe that comes close. Instead of getting sucked into the audiophile marketing black hole, take a step back and look at the G6. At $180, this thing provides true bang for your dollar results. topping SMSL shit and feel can learn some big lessons from the granddaddy of DAC companies.